Hi, everybody. I am, well, it's been a day, let me tell you. First off, let's go through what we're going to do tonight. I'll put up the spreadsheets in a second, but we're going to go through this 2013 box of Prizm. It's the jumbo box, so it's got some exclusive color parallels in it and, twice the signatures that Hobby has and that kind of jazz. Same thing, 2014's a jumbo box. We're going to do it second. Third up was supposed to be our first third of the case of the new 2016 plates and patches. Well, guess what? Panini moved the release date again. So it was supposed to be the first of the month, got rescheduled, was supposed to have been today. And then when I called to say, hey, when can I, come pick up my case? Because I've got breaks all weekend. Oh no, guess what? Local hobby shop owner says, oh no, it's moved again. Doesn't come out until the 24th. Online all week, it said came out today. No, did not come out today. Now, of course, the online people have switched it, but fat lot of good that does us now. So if you are part of that break for plates and patches, I will be sending out more info as I get it, which should be probably midweek. Meanwhile, here's what we have up tonight. Our 2013 Prizm Jumbo is up first. I guess the moral of the story tonight is I guess nobody likes Prizm in football but me, or maybe you guys just don't like the jumbo boxes. I don't know. But lots of teams did not sell. A couple of teams, I guess, were. Yeah, a couple teams unpaid, a bunch of teams didn't sell, and that kind of thing. So I'm thinking maybe this is not like a super popular product. I kind of thought Prizm was. I love Prizm. And honestly, some of the Prizm cards, even the unsigned ones, bring a lot of money. Later this weekend, I've got a box of 2012 Prizm going up, and good grief, I mean, there's a That's the first year they did Prizm, by the way, was 2012. And there are a ton of cards in there that, graded book for triple digits, even ungraded are high double digits. So I don't know. I don't know why nobody likes it. I mean, some of you guys obviously do. And Michael, yes. And Fred, I appreciate you guys jumping in there. And you definitely did your part in helping out with that. But I guess it's just not as popular as I thought it was. So there you go, live and learn. All right, so there's lots of packs in here and lots of cards in each pack. So this is kind of a base heavy set, and so will 2014 be. These jumbo boxes are loaded up, and that's all right because we're going to find some good stuff in here. And then all the people who didn't bid on it are going to be mega jealous, right? That's what I'm thinking. Now, I have a new band-aid tonight. See, I have an owl. I don't really want to. I'm like, it's the bad finger, so I'm trying to show it in a way that's non-offensive. Yeah, I just like got a tiny little snag on it, and I thought, opening cards. I don't want to take a chance that it should suddenly start bleeding or anything. Okay, guys, for the base cards, because this is a base heavy set, I'm just going to kind of hold them up there for a minute, and we're going to roll right on through. Obviously, the prisms and things like that, well, I should say the refractors, we'll stop on. As Prism calls them all prisms, but refractors are really refractors, no matter if they want to call them prism prisms or not. So I think we've got four autographs that'll be somewhere in this case, in addition to our parallels and any other short prints that might be in here. And hopefully everyone got there, or most of you probably. Hey, Brett Kiesel. Yay, Fear the Beard. I think most everybody probably has their packages by now of your other cards from breaks other than yesterday and the day before. Okay, so this is one of the light blue parallels, which is exclusive to the jumbo box. You would not find this in the regular 2013 Prizm. So that's kind of nice. And that Des Bryant on it is even better. So that's a nice little, I mean, I guess technically not by the truest sense of the word a hit, but yet I would definitely consider it a hit. Eddie Lacy rookie. Tavon Austin rookie. Jordan Poyer rookie. And Cordell Patterson, the little HRX card. You know, not actually the talking one, but just the regular card. So anyway, I don't know how much you guys collect based on value versus, you know, just teams you like, players you like, things like that. But if you ever deep dive into value, you'll be amazed at how some of the Prizm, even non-signed, you know, and obviously non-memorabilia, some of the kind of dollar figures attached to a few of these Prizm cards. I mean, they are impressive on some of them. As I say, especially out of that 2012 set, I'm really excited to get into that thing. I think maybe that's, I can't remember if that's tomorrow or Sunday that that ends, but it's not a jumbo though, because I couldn't find a jumbo. I did well to find the regular hobby box of 2012. But, you know, still has a couple of autographs and lots of parallels in it, even being the regular box. So I'm still excited about it. Rookie Impact. Sometimes these inserts do well also in Prism. Brilliance for the Texans, Andre Johnson. This is another, I'm pretty sure, let me pick up this box. Yeah. Light blue and purple. So this is another Prism color that is exclusive to the jumbo box. So in 2013, the exclusive colors are blue and purple. So our first one was Dez Bryant, of course, for the Cowboys. And our second one is a rookie card of Kenny Vaccaro, headed off to the Saints. And then here's our other rookies in this pack. Alex Okafor for the Cardinals. Marcus Lattimore for the 49ers. And Derek Rogers for the Bills. And then there's our little HRX rookie card for Marquise Goodwin. Honestly, I don't really get those HRX rookie cards. I mean, the ones that, you know, the series where they actually had some talking cards and stuff. Now, cool. But just the little, you know, kind of weirdo insert that says that and isn't a Prism print is just kind of weird to me that that's in the Prism set. But, oh well, what are you going to do? I guess they can put in there whatever they want to put in there. Just like they can ship our cases whenever they want to ship them, instead of the first time they say it's coming or the second time they say it's coming, and they make us wait yet again. And if it doesn't actually come in next Friday, I'm going to be mega unhappy. Here's another little rookie impact insert, Barcavius Mingo for the Browns. Oh, looks like this might be possibly a signature hit. Terrence Williams for the Cowboys, usually when they're facing the wrong way. Indeed. So our first signature hit out of this is Terrence Williams for the Dallas Cowboys. Oh, nice little Matthew Stafford brilliance insert. That's cool. Here is another one of our exclusive light blue prisms. This is Jacoby Ford, also for the Raiders. Why did I say also for the Raiders? Our other one was for the Saints. I think I have an, like a little mini stroke or something. I don't know why I said also for the Raiders, but anyway. A rookie Monty Ball for the Broncos. Rookie Deion Jordan for the Dolphins. Rookie Stephon Taylor for the Cardinals. And Eddie Lacy in our weird little HRX card that nobody gets why it's in there. But honestly, no matter what we pull out of here, you know, I don't think we had. I think the Steelers were the only bid that we had that maybe went over like $2 or $2.25. So pretty much any hit that you get in here, I think will be a bargain in relation to what the selling price was. RG3. Maybe we'll knock one out of the park and pull something awesome. All right, looks like this is going to be our second signature hit. And it is Chris Gregg, I think that's how you say it, for the Bills. And this guy, I find him in a lot of 2013 stuff. I mean, obviously I know he was rookie in 2013, but There were lots of other rookies in 2013 too, but I pulled this guy quite a bit, actually. Nice little Jack Ham Decade of Dominance insert card for the Steelers. Cool little hit. Another one of our light blue, and it's die cut, so awesome. Maybe wish it had been a slightly different player, but there's Kevin Minter for the Cardinals. Would rather have that been like Le'Veon Bell, for instance. But the nice die cut in the exclusive light blue color. Rookie. Cool. Marcus Davis, rookie. DeMontis Moore, rookie. Quentin Patton, rookie. And Deion Jordan, weird HRX rookie. Michael, how are you and Fred doing? Have you had a good week? Anything interesting or good happen? Been kind of boring around here. Pretty much run of the mill. Nothing too exciting. You guys are the only ones I see in chat. There may be some other people watching. And I would say hi to you guys too if you were chatting, but you're not. So I only know that Michael and Fred are here. Stevie Johnson, yay, ex-UK player. Pulled a lot of Cowboys out of here. Roddy White, Frank Gore. We pulled a Frank Gore signature out of something the other day. Another decade of dominance. Warren Sapp for the Bucks. One of our Blue Prism Stedman Bailey for the Rams. It says St. Louis on there. Obviously, they've moved to LA, so it will go to the LA Rams. Rex Burkhead, rookie for the Bengals. Eric Reed, rookie for the 49ers. There's a Le'Veon Bell rookie. Why can't we have a signature on that, huh? Yeah. Where's the love on that? Denard Robinson. And I'm just going to scoot. This little pile is getting a little tall, so I'm going to just scoot it right over here so that we can start ourselves a new pile without having that one grow to gigantic proportions. You're hoping for a good Broncos hit. All right, I'll see what I can do about that. We'll see if we can't find you an exceptional Bronco somewhere in here. Mr. Andrew Luck. I'm still so excited that we pulled his signed rookie card the other day out of 2012 Prime Sigs. That was awesome. That made me very happy. I imagine it made whoever got it pretty happy too, all things considered. Michael Crabtree. All right. Oh, here's gonna be looks like our is this are you kidding me? Is this gonna be two another signature hit for the Buffalo Bills, Derrick Rogers? Okay, so far we've had three signatures and two of them have gone to the Buffalo Bills. So I don't really remember who has the Bills, but whoever you are, you should play the lottery today because you're having good luck. Pierre Garçon, M. Well, Monday Night Heroes, so MNH insert. Always want to say MVP. Oh, this is cool, little Reggie Bush Lions Blue Prism. Fun. Corey Fuller rookie. Nick Casa rookie. Deion Sims rookie. And DeAndre Hopkins HRX card. All right, so we should be finding at least one more signature in here. Or the Chiefs, or the Texans, or the Vikings. Okay, so you want Broncos, Chiefs, Texans, Vikings. All right. Well, I'm vibing it, because I'm vibing that everybody gets a hit that bid, because, there's a lot of teams that were not sold. So those of you who were kind enough to participate, I certainly hope you do hit something nice out of here. Because I appreciate the bid. I was going to buy some 2015 Prism, like not Jumbo. I already have a Jumbo that ends sometime this weekend, but regular hobby box, but I'm kind of rethinking that now. Here is another Monday Night Heroes insert. This one for the 49ers, Michael Crabtree. There's another purple Prism, Justin Blackman for the Jags. That kind of looks like cracked ice, doesn't it? I mean, a little bit. I guess maybe no, they don't all look like that. That looks a bit cracked ice to me. Does that not look that way to you? It does to me. Yeah, it is numbered. 28 of 40, if you can. There you go. That way you can see it at that angle. Yeah, I'm feeling like that is cracked ice right there. Because none of our others have had. We'll go through them again in a minute, but I don't think any of our others have had that. Have a Zach Ertz, rookie for the Eagles. A Landry Jones, rookie for the Steelers. Cordell Patterson, rookie for the Vikings. And Keenan Allen, HRX, rookie for the Chargers. Is that right? Yeah, Chargers. Oops, I gotta get Mr. Wake picked up off the table there. Yeah, the Justin Blackmon. I'm fairly certain that is. I mean, they may not have called it cracked ice in 2013 since it was only the second year of Prizm, but pretty certain that that is what that is. All right, let's see who we can find in here. Ray Rice. Man, that's a shame that that guy decided to do the things he did because he was a heck of a football player, but probably not a great guy in real life based on, beating up women and whatnot. But nope, you all hear my little kitty. Always talks. Here we have an insert for the Bears, Gale Sayers, Decade of Dominance. Our blue prism here is Steve Smith for Carolina. Jonathan Franklin, rookie for Green Bay. Ace Sanders, rookie for the Jags. Manti Te'o, rookie for the Chargers. And Monte Ball, HRX, rookie card. Right, so our other signature is hiding out. You guys think it's going to be in the left pack or the right pack? I don't know. I'm feeling like it might be in the. Feeling like it might be in the right pack. And so, I got a 50-50 shot of being right on that. So you'll either be like, oh, you're a genius, or you'll say, you have no idea what you're, vibing there. But we'll go on that and see if maybe we can hold it to our last pack for some little suspense to the very end. Lots of Steelers in here. Not really the one we want, which is the signed Le'Veon Bell, but still a lot of good Steelers cards in here. For our Steelers fans. Oh, this is going to be our signature because I see one turned to the back. Let's slide him around. We're going to move him around and save him to the very end of the pack. Our blue prism here is Vic Ballard for the Indianapolis Colts. Of course, we have our rookies in a different order now because I've just changed the order of the pack. Tyler Bray for the Chiefs. Cornelius Carradine for the 49ers. Ontario McCallus for the Bengals. Matt Barkley, HRX, rookie. Carson Palmer. All right, so who is our hit going to be? Who's our signature going to be? This is our last signature in here. I see a lot of red. And oh, yep, feeling like we're going to have 49ers. Indeed, we do. Oh boy, cannot even think about pronouncing. Oh my goodness. This is one of the black parallels, kids. So even though this may not be like the hottest, greatest player in the world, or maybe he is and I just don't know him, these black parallels are uncommon, I think, in here. At least they are less common than the others. You don't see the black signature parallels like every day, so that is I think that's a pretty good hit, probably, even though I don't know the player on it. Then Decade of Dominance here for Bart Starr for the Packers. All right, so we have one pack left for our 2013 Prism Jumbo box. Let's see what exciting stuff that holds. All right. See, more Steelers. Lots of Steelers in this base set. I see at least another blue prism hiding back there. We'll see who's on there. How do you guys say this guy's name? Is his last name Sa or So? Rookie impact for the 49ers, Vance McDonald. Jason Witten, brilliance insert. Our last blue prism out of here is Jonathan Cyprian or Cyprian, also for the Jags. What up with all the blue prism Jags? Tavarius King, rookie. Jonathan Banks, rookie. Alex Ogletree, rookie. And Robert Woods, HRX, rookie. All right, so let's take a look at our prism parallels and our signatures before, and that'll wrap up our 2013 break, and we'll take a look then at our spreadsheet for 2014. All right, so we have the Jags, a blue parallel, which I don't know what they call that particular pattern right there. If you can see, I mean, you can kind of see the pattern in it, but I don't know what that, if that pattern's considered the wave or something else, I'm not certain. Vic Ballard for the Colts. Steve Smith, Carolina. Our Justin Blackmon, which was numbered to 40. And I'm 99.9% sure that we call that cracked ice, right? I sometimes get the name of these wrong on these parallels, but I'm pretty sure that is. I was just double-checking the back of the blue ones. I didn't think that they were numbered, but I just decided to double check it. Reggie Bush for Detroit. Stedman Bailey for St. Louis. Kevin Minter for Arizona, and that's the nice die cut as well. So got a couple of good things happening there with Kevin Minter. Jacoby Ford for the Raiders. Kenny Vaccaro, this is another kind of cracked ice one, but here's Dez Bryant first out of our blue one. So let's take a look and see what Kenny here is numbered. Is he numbered? Yes, he is. He is 26 of 40. My screen keeps going to sleep over there. 26 of 40 for the Kenny Vaccaro purple prism. So both of these numbered to 40, which is nice. Nice hits. And just, there's definitely nothing on the blue ones. And then out of our signatures for this break, we have our black signature, which I'll have to do some research on that. I really expected that to be numbered because I do not think there are very many at all of these black signature prisms, unless maybe there were in 2013 and I'm just not remembering it, but I don't remember there being very many of them. Anyway, so guy whose name we can't say for the 49ers on the black signature, black parallel signature, Derek Rogers for the Bills. Another Bills hit with Chris Gregg. And then a Cowboys hit for Terrence Williams. So those are our four signatures and all of our various multicolored parallels, which wraps up 2013. So let me just get these. I want to get these guys set aside, all of 2013 set aside before we get into 2014. Because obviously we don't want to get any of this stuff mixed together or anything like that. So I want to make sure everything is in its proper home before we crack into 2014. But I just love the prism cards. I mean, I think they're cool. So I don't know why they weren't super popular tonight. Maybe it's just you guys don't love the jumbo boxes. Maybe the hobby boxes are more the thing that people prefer. I don't know. Black Auto, maybe print run numbered to 10. See, again, that's what I thought. I thought they might have even been a 1 of 1 as opposed to a numbered to 10. But I can find no number on this guy. I mean, I just see zero numbers on him. But this is, I'm just virtually certain that this is a very limited print run. And I don't understand why I cannot see a number on it. I mean, unless in 2013 that they were not numbering them. And just the fact that it was the black parallel was the limited component. But I am... just virtually certain that is an extremely low numbered card or a low print run card, however you want to say it. Anyhow, let's take a look here at who is in 2014 Jumbo Box. There were certainly not as many unsold here, but still not a supremely popular box for whatever reason. And I kind of thought it would be, honestly. But, 2014 more so than 13, I guess. And then, of course, 15 even more so than that. But I don't know. I guess we'll find out about 15 and 12 and the rest of them. All right, so. Oh, let me see what this chat message says. Oh, all right. Well, that's good then. Okay, if he likes the Packers and he's okay with, and he's okay with base cards, then yes, he should like those because he'll have a bunch coming. All right, so print run only. What are you telling me, Fred? Print run only. What does that mean? Like, so is it a one of one like I originally thought, or no? I mean, I really thought the black signatures were one of one, but since it didn't have one of one on it, then I thought maybe I was wrong. And I'm not entirely sure what print run only, what you're telling me with that. I'm not too bright sometimes. This would be one of those times, I guess, because I don't know what that print run only means. Actually, there's probably lots of those times I kind of have lapses or senior moments or whatever we want to call them. All right, so here's all of our little packs for 2014. So this is our second break tonight. And again, being the jumbo box, there's going to be tons and tons of cards in here. So we're going to do kind of the same thing. I will hold the base up long enough for you guys to get a look at it, but we're not particularly going to dwell on it unless there's something interesting about it. Just one of those little inserty advertising as at blah 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 me talk pretty one day advertisement things. All right, so right off the top we've got some rookies here. So we have a little rookie for the Jet, Taj Boyd, Troy Nicholas, rookie for the Cards. These have a completely different feel to them, by the way. I mean, the card stock, the whole shebang is different. They're a different weight, they're a different everything than 2013, and they kind of have a tendency to want to stick together. Kyle Fuller, rookie for the Bears, means not serial stamp number on the card. Okay, but did you find out if it was a one of one or not? Is there any? I've got my price book around here somewhere, and maybe it will tell me in there, but all right, so here's a little refractor here of DeMarcus Ware. You can see the little rainbow colors picking up in it there. So I don't know, should I mean, technically, well, we'll set it aside. It's one of those sort of things like, do you call it a hit? Do you not call it a hit? It kind of is, kind of isn't. Seahawks, Legion of Boom insert. I like that. But yeah, these cards are, I don't know. They just have a completely different feel to them. Different everything. I don't know. It's weird. You'll see when you get them. If anybody bought into 13 and 14 and you get cards from both, you'll see what I mean when you pick up, 14 and just feel solely different than 13. And thank you for telling me what print run only meant. I don't know why I don't, that just didn't connect with me. I did not get that. I did not know what that meant. I'm telling you guys, man, one of those days. Rookies out of this pack, Tom Savage for the Texans, Jake Matthews for the Falcons, Teddy Bridgewater. Now there's a signature we want to find in here somewhere for the Vikes, because signature Teddy Bridgewater out of this set, graded, is probably about a $100 card. Ungraded, probably 50 or so. And looks like we've got a hit hiding behind Mr. Bridgewater here. Indeed, we do. We have a Marion. Does that say Grice? I think it does. Rookie signature. And numbered 63 of 150 for the Chargers. And I would believe that would be considered camo, in my opinion. I think that that is going to be considered a camo card, prism, insert, whatever you want to call it. Hit. It is a hit. Obviously, it's signed. Another Taj Boyd rookie. So Taj is full of rookies in here. Clayton is stoked. Two Packers in a row. That's good. That's good. I hope we can find some more Packers for him in here. And you know, I've probably got a big pile of Packers cards somewhere. So I'll have to, one of these days, when I get my mountain of cards organized by team and such, I will, you know, maybe I can send you a few extra little Packers cards and things for him. But problem is, I have to get the mountain of cards sorted into teams first, and oh boy, that is going to be a project of the large kind. Is it going to be a large project? Oh, sorry, that's Blake Bortles, rookie for the Jags. Aaron Donald, rookie for the Rams. That's kind of a different feel to it than the others, but it's not any different, but it feels different, heavier. Isaiah Crowell for the Browns, rookie. Mike Evans for the Bucks, rookie. Oh, how about that? Then he likes this, right? Okay, here's a little Brett Favre action. Again, I'm thinking that is probably considered the camo background. So, it's not numbered that I see anywhere, but still, it's a cool little card there for Mr. Brett Favre. Nice little insert or camo. Now, this pattern for sure has a name. This one may actually be the wave. The pattern may be called the wave on this little guy here for Ace Sanders. I'm just terrible, honestly, of remembering all the pattern names in Prism. It is 93 of 99. One of these days, maybe I will retain them all, but like I look at it and I think I know it, and then the next time I see one, it's like, oh yeah, no, that really wasn't it. I'm going to set Aaron Rodgers over here because he is different. I think it's considered camo, but at any rate, we're setting him over there. We're considering him an insert. And the other night, I forgot and set one of my hits in the pile of base cards for Prime Signature. So then when I did my hit recap, of course, I didn't mention it because I had accidentally stacked it with the base cards. And then, you know, I sit here when I get done and put everything in sleeves and holders and all that jazz. I'm like, wait a minute, where is my other hit for 2011? I can't find it. Did I get shorted one? And then, no, I had it in the base cards. So I do generally try to keep them out separate. Cody Latimer for the Broncos, rookie. Paul Richardson, Seahawk, rookie. Jimmy Garoppolo, Patriots, rookie. Greg Jennings for the Vikings. This is another one of our refractor cards here. We will set him over there. Chris Borland, rookie with, again, the camo background for the 49ers. We're going to set him over there for that reason. I guess we should look and see if he is numbered. He is not. And did we look at Greg Jennings? Let's look at him, too. No, he is not either. All right, so let's see who else we've got. We haven't found any. We found one of our signatures, one. Our first pack there had one of the signatures, our second pack. Jerry Rice. Good times. Had lots of Cowboys in here, too. Just, you know, again, base, but still. All right, and we got another Kid Reporter card. You never hear about that. Like, does anybody win that contest? I never hear about Kid Reporter. Jason Verrett, Chargers rookie. Josh Huff, Eagles rookie. DeAnthony Thomas, Chiefs rookie. Oh, this is a nice insert for the Bengals. Die-cut insert. Pretty cool, huh? Yeah, believe the hype. Very nice. AJ McCarron. Very cool die-cut there. I think we have another die-cut right behind it, which is why I set the pack down. Larry Fitzgerald, Cardinals, hands team die-cut insert. Also, that is not numbered either, but I always like the inserts. I think they're a lot of fun. Something out of the ordinary. And I enjoy them. Gronk. We pulled the Rob Gronkowski signature rookie card out of something last week, too. Maybe it was week before last. I think it was last week, though. So we pulled some good rookie hits recently. Hoping we find a good one in here for you guys. I mean, there's several possibilities of who could be in here. We just have to conjure them up and have them appear. We need our mojo to bring us some good luck. Davante Adams, Packers rookie. Kyle Van Noy, Lions rookie. Oh, another Packers rookie, Jared. Abreteris. We're going with that. Another nice die cut. It's going to be another two die cuts in a row. Davante Adams. How about that? How about three Packers right there in a row? One of them is nice die cut rookie for Davante Adams. We have another Believe the Hype AJ McCarron. Rookie and all, but like, I don't need two in the same box. Maybe we could have had a slightly different die cut, but all right. And then we're back on our regular veteran base cards here. But it is nice that they put lots of rookies in the Prism sets. I enjoy that. And again, sometimes you guys, these Prism rookie cards, even though they're not signed or and they're not materials cards, some of them in certain years really bring a decent amount of money. And you know, a lot of you guys probably know that already, but some of you maybe if you just collect for fun and things like that, you might not be as aware of that. And so if you have a bunch of those laying around somewhere, check them out. Might have something worth more than you think. Anthony Barr, Vikings rookie. I'll start a new pile over here for these. Bishop Sankey, Titans rookie. Ryan Shazier, all right, Steelers rookie. Tony Romo for the Cowboys. And he's a refractor. I see our little rainbow colors there. He is not numbered, but we're still going to set him over there. Well, this is a, is that guy a refractor too? I guess maybe he looks, does he look rainbowy to you? Does a little bit to me. Johnny Manziel rookie. And this red, this insert is numbered. Yep, I thought it was going to be 59 of 175. I could not remember if it was the more limited or the less limited out of the color inserts. So still cool little Johnny Manziel hit if you are a Johnny fan. Another guy that, man, I wish he hadn't washed out because he's a great player, but he just personally got off track a little bit, I guess. Maybe he'll get it straightened out and get back on the field one of these days. All right, so we have left here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we're about halfway through 2014. There's that. Oh, there's an Odell Beckham Jr. rookie. Darqueze Dennard, rookie for the Bengals. Stephon Tuitt, rookie for the Steelers. There's some good little Steelers hits in here. Oh, nice die cut. Air Marshals. Russell Wilson. Yeah, that's very cool. Very cool. Little die cut intros. Alex Smith for the Chiefs. Some more Steelers. Big Ben. Lance Alworth insert for the Chargers. And then we're just back through our kind of regular veteran base players through here. And let me move these guys on top of this. All right, so we definitely, we've got to have some signatures hiding here in these last few packs, don't we? We pulled the one signature so far. And there's that. Jeremy Hill, rookie for the Bengals. Storm Johnson, rookie for the Jags. Chris Borland, rookie for the 49ers. Oh, here's one of our signatures. Jeremy Hill for the Bengals. Camo background. Number 25 of 100. Our die cut in here is Hands Team Julian Edelman for the Patriots. Oh, here's a rainbow refractor. Isaiah Crowell for the Browns, his rookie card. And that should be very low numbered, and it is 10 of 25. So that is a nice hit there for the Browns. Yeah, well, we'll just keep it there with that. And then we're into our base here for our veteran players. It seems weird, doesn't it, seeing Brett Favre in a Vikings uniform? I mean, you like kind of almost forget that he did a little stint up there towards the end, but it seems kind of weird to see him in a Viking uniform. It does to me, anyway. There's something about it just isn't right with the world. All right, we have Terrence West, rookie for the Browns. Marion Grice, rookie for the Chargers. Oh, this is nice. Ha ha, Clinton Dix, rookie for the Packers. Fresh Faces, Bishop Sankey, die cut for the Titans. LaDainian Washington for the Cowboys, rookie. And this guy's going to be, I thought, numbered, but he's not numbered. I thought that he would be, but he is not. Here is our next signature, LaMarcus Joyner for the Rams. And he is 120 of 150. So there's our third signature. They're just all coming right here in a row now, aren't they? And then we've got our base hanging out in here, the bus. Tons and tons of Jason Witten cards. And that looks like that's cut off center. I guess it's not, but looks kind of like it is. I don't know. And then LeSean McCoy. All right, so we have two packs left. And once again, we're still looking for our last autograph when we get down to the last two packs. Jarvis Landry, rookie for the Dolphins. Eric Ebron, rookie for the Lions. Shaq Evans, rookie for the Jets. Camo insert rookie for Tom Savage with the Texans. And I still kind of set those aside, just, you know. Matthew Stafford for the Lions. I'm guessing that's not going to be numbered because the other one in similar coloring was not. And our last signature hit. Oh, Michael Sam. All right. Cool hit for the Rams. Cool hit. Michael Sam, 101 of 200. Nice. Like it. And then we've just got some all about that base. I watched one guy break, and it was like a base heavy set. Tons of base. And he would just, it was like, I'm going to date myself here, but it was kind of like a Ferris Bueller thing. You know how they go, Bueller, Bueller, Bueller. Yeah. So this guy would just go, base, base, base. Kills me. Brandon Cooks, rookie for the Saints. It's actually a decent hit, too. Marquise Lee, rookie for the Jags. Johnny Manziel, rookie for the Browns. Die-cut Peyton Manning, Air Marshals. Not numbered. There's a Derek Johnson for the Chiefs, a refractor. Josh McCown for the Buccaneers. Numbered 250, 40 of 50. And Alex Smith, DeAndre Hopkins, CJ Spiller, Tom Rathman, Jamal Charles, and Tony Romo wraps it up. So again, if anybody jumped in late, 2016 Plates and Patches, the release date was moved again. So that did not come into the hobby store today, so nobody has them. It's not just my store that didn't get them. None of the stores got them because Panini moved the release date. So that is currently set to release for next Friday, the 24th. I will reach out to everybody again via eBay messages between now and then, as soon as I can confirm something one way or the other as to whether or not they're actually going to arrive on the 24th, I will send out the notice for the rescheduled break day and time. So the minute I get them in my hands, we will crack into them and break them. I was super disappointed that we didn't have them tonight. But unfortunately, not much we can do about it. So our signature hits out of 2014 Prizm, we had Michael Sam for the Rams, numbered 101 of 200. We had LaMarcus Joyner, also for the Rams, numbered 120 of 150. Isn't it weird? We got two Bills signatures out of the other one. We get two Rams signatures out of this one. Jeremy Hill, Bengals, numbered 25 of 100. And Marion Bryce for the Chargers, numbered 63 of 150. Then, just for fun, we're going to go through these little inserts and our various refractors and things. So, just because I think, it's fun to take a look again. So, we had a DeMarcus Ware refractor, not numbered. Troy Nicholas rookie refractor, not numbered. Tony Romo, little rainbow refractor there. I guess basically none of the refractors are going to be numbered, so I guess there's really no reason to flip them all over. Die cut AJ McCarron, Believe the Hype rookie card. Devontae Adams, die cut rookie for the Packers. Die cut hands team for the Cardinals. Larry Fitzgerald, our second AJ McCarron die cut. Chris Borland, rookie, which is really just, I set him aside because he's got kind of the camo background. Greg Jennings, refractor for the Vikes. Brett Favre with the camo background. Ace Sanders for the Jags with, again, I think this is pattern is maybe called the Wave. 93 of 99. Not 100% sure if it's called the Wave, but Josh McCown for the Bucks. Numbered 40 of 50, and I don't really know what we call this one. I'm gonna just guess probably blue refractor because primary color is blue and it's a refractor, but what they officially named it, I'm not certain. Derek Johnson for the Chiefs, just a unnumbered refractor. Air Marshals insert, Peyton Manning. Tom Savage for the Texans, rookie with the camo background. Bishop Sankey die cut rookie for the Titans. Isaiah Crowell, this is our rainbow refractor, or I think that's what they call it in this set, and it's number 10 of 25, so that is a nice low number there. Then our die cut hands team, Julian Edelman for the Patriots. Whoops, Julian, you kind of went crazy on me there. Alex Smith, Kansas City die cut, and Air Marshals die cut for Russell Wilson, and then our Johnny Manziel. Well, Johnny, I'd like to have you cooperate with me here, bud. Our Johnny Manziel red refractor, which is number 59 of 125. All right, so that is it for tonight, guys. Again, anybody who's in 2016 plates and patches, please keep an eye on your eBay messages. I will send an update of some sort on Wednesday, whether I know what we're doing or whether I don't. I will update you in the middle of the week and say, hey, here's where we are. Everything is going to ship that's broken the last 2 or 3 nights, including what I just broke tonight. My intention is for all of that to go out tomorrow. So, knock wood, if nothing happens, that will all go out tomorrow. You'll have it in a couple of days. So, as always, thank you guys so much for hanging out with me, for spending your time, spending your money. Always appreciated. Those of you who do like Prizm, I hope you will check out the 2015 Jumbo Box and the 2012 Hobby Box, which I'm really excited about. That's coming up over the weekend. And then we've got a bunch of other stuff too, some Crown Royal from 10, 2010, 2011, 2013, 2014. I've got some more 2016 Prime Signatures, 2011 Prime Sigs, 2016 Clear Vision. We got a lot of stuff coming up. I'm excited about all of it. So hopefully I will see some or most or all of you again. And thank you very much. Appreciate it. Have a great weekend.